Art, to me, a lot of it is self-expression, which is why sometimes being an artist for a living can feel weird and very like a selfish thing, because all I'm doing day in and day out is just like interpreting the world onto a canvas, but it's my point of view constantly. But I guess, you know, one of my desires when people look at my work is I would hope that they would find some type of connection, that there's some type of ability for human connection in the work, whether even despite how abstract it can be. So I would say art is, yeah, an interpretation of the world and of, yeah, life on Earth. At least for me, like that's my approach to all my work. Okay, I first started painting about 4 or 5 years ago. Yeah, one day I just went to my brother's grabbed his paints from high school, and just started messing around with them. And then I kind of got attached to that form of expression and kept doing it. And I got a lot of encouragement from everyone around me, and it kind of spurred me on to keep doing it. So yeah, that's how I started. So I grew up in a house with 7 siblings. I'm the second oldest, and so like it eventually became 7 other siblings. But I had all brothers at one point, and then sisters started coming along. But we all lived in like a tiny house in Homewood, and we lived on top of each other because there was no room in that house whatsoever. We were all homeschooled, so we spent all day every day together. Yeah, I think that there was definitely a lot of freedom to be creative in our family, and my dad is maybe not super creative, but he was artistic, and so I think that those genes were, like the artistic genes were in a lot of us. And then my parents were they definitely encouraged any creativity in us that they saw. So it never felt stifled, it always felt like there was freedom to explore. I always say that like my Aunt Amy was a huge supporter. She saw the creativity in me, in the artist in me at a really young age, and she would always, and she's an artist herself, and I like was, she was one of my heroes. I was obsessed with her, so I saw all of like the creative expression in her life, and I wanted to mirror that. And then I think she saw creativity and she saw herself in me. My grandfather, and I admire him a lot too. He's another person that kind of is always in my head. Him and my brother Adam, they're all huge like inspirations and people that kind of like sit up here in my head when I'm just throughout all of life, and I'm kind of subconsciously wanting to, you kind of mimic, maybe not mimic the things they do, but like they all inspire. It's really rare to have an idea and have a feeling and want to convey it in a painting and then it actually work out. So a lot of times when I get up to my studio, I spend a good amount of time reading, looking at photographs, gathering ideas. And then I'll turn some music on and put my sweatpants on, covered in paint, and then just start to actually work. But sometimes it takes me hours to actually get to painting. And there are some days that I don't paint at all. I'll come up here and just gather ideas and kind of take notes really on color and get thoughts together. So I wouldn't say that my relationship with God affects my work. I feel like it's like the only source of me working at all. I feel like creativity and creating is like sometimes feels like completely out of my hands. Like sometimes making a painting, it feels like something that like I cannot do on my own. And even though it's a skill I've acquired and I've learned like as a human being, and I kind of know what I'm doing in a sense, I think kind of like the broader realm of creativity is so otherworldly and so much bigger than me that it is like, it is the presence of God. It's all kind of a conversation with God, I would say. and something that I partner with God in. I kind of feel like we make my work together. Like he and I work on these paintings together. Yeah, I think I was really drawn to a type of creative expression where there were no rules, and I found a lot of freedom in that. And and also without having any training, any classical training in art, and just kind of going off of what I just like playing with my brother's paints on my bedroom floor, that's all I really knew to do was just kind of like play with color in a really abstract way. But it was a really great fit for me because it was just, I don't know, I felt like it communicated a lot, and I enjoyed going into that realm where I could create, but there weren't rules. Oh my gosh, it's so fleeting. I feel like it's just this passing thing, and I get a little taste of it like every once in a while, and I never know when it's gonna come, and I never know when it'll leave. So it can be really, you can't rely on inspiration to create, especially when you're doing it full time like I am. So a lot of days I'll come up here and I don't feel anything. Sometimes I'll go to other things. I'll go to photographs or reading or film or things like that to spark some, to get my creative juices flowing. But some days you're not feeling it at all. And for people like me, and it's my only source of income, I have to create anyway. And those days can be hard. And the other day, I was really frustrated and upset with my work and my lack of ideas, and I realized I had been coming up here every day for the last, 3 weeks, and I hadn't given myself a break. And I had a good friend tell me, like, you've got to get out of the studio and you have to give yourself a break. And since I do it full time, sometimes I feel like that's lazy. I feel like, no, this is my only job. I have to show up every day, and I have to, but sometimes that hurts me as an artist. So yeah, I got on the bus for like 3 hours and just rode around the city and read and met people and talked to the bus driver and things like that, really helped me a lot to kind of get thoughts and inspiration flowing again. Okay, risks. I would say doing art for a living, doing art at all for anyone that even plays around with art, is an extremely vulnerable thing. And especially if you get to, it's vulnerable when you are sharing it with the world. So that feels like even doing it 5 years now and using social media, like posting my work on social media, it's hard to even explain how vulnerable that can feel sometimes. And I kind of have to brace myself and like talk myself off the ledge sometimes. Because, you're putting something that you've poured your heart into, something that means something to you, and you're putting it out into the world. So that almost feels like a daily, like hourly risk with my career. Because a lot of times, like, what you make and what means something to you won't resonate with other people, and that's fine. It doesn't mean that it's not, it wasn't worth your time to make, and it doesn't mean that there's no value to it, but it can be really hard to put something out there and not get a positive response. So, talk about vulnerability. That was very hard for me too. To put a price on something that I made, to ask somebody for money for something that I made. I think a lot of artists struggle with that. I don't feel like I've really had to sacrifice anything to actually follow like this art journey or making art my career. I feel like doing this for a living is the most that I've felt like in my skin in any job I've ever had. So I felt like the sacrifices that I've had to make for jobs were for the jobs I had in the past that were not really like a fit for me. This, doing this for a living, just it's like I felt so much freedom to explore what I really think about things, what I love, and freedom to just create in this medium that I really love. So it hardly feels like sacrifice. There are hard days, but there are hard days where the inspiration's not coming, or when you have a soul in a while and you're wondering, and, you know, rent, it's harder to make rent, and months like that that are discouraging, but overall, it's, yeah, it's been one of the best seasons of my life.